Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 48 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. Today we are going to look into question number 85. You have an Azure Active Directory tenant named adatom.com that contains the groups shown in the following table. So we do have group 1, Active Directory group is member of nothing, means it is not member of any other group. Group 2 is the member of group 1. Group 3 is the member of group 2. And adatom.com contains the users shown in the following table. So user 1 is the member of group 1. User 2 is the member of group 2. User 3 the member of group 3. And user 4 is not the member of any of the group. You assign the Azure Active Directory premium plan two licenses to group 1 and user 4. Which users are assigned the Azure Active Directory premium plan two licenses? Here examiner would like to test our knowledge about inheritance of the licenses to the subgroups. So we will visualize it through a diagram. So I have created this diagram based on our question that group 1 is the group which is not member of any of other group, and group 1 is having user 1 as a member in that group 1. Further, group 2 is a member of group 1, so that is overlapping, and group 2 has a user in it, which is the user 2. Again, the group 3 is again the member of group 2, which is connected to group 2, and have user 3, the member of group 3. And user 4 is not the member of any of above groups. Please note these all groups are Active Directory security groups, and we are going to create the similar scenario on Azure Active Directory. So let's go to Azure portal. We are in Azure portal. We'll go to Active Directory, we'll go to groups, and we do not have any group. We'll create group 1. It's what would be a security group. Name is group 1. Group description will keep nothing, and Azure role will keep it default. Membership is assigned, and we'll create group 1. Group 1 is created. Now we will create group 2. Security group 2. Create again group 3. Create. We'll go to groups. Group 1, group 2 is created, and group 3 is created as well. So 3 of 3 group are created now. And now here we'll make group 2 member of group 1. So we'll go to group 1 and add as a member. Add member. We'll say group 2. Select. So group 2 is the member of group 1 now. Refresh. So group 2 is the member of group 1 now. Now we'll go to group 2. We are in group 2. We'll look for the members and we'll add member, which is our group 3. And group 3 is the member of group 2 now. Now let's see the users. We'll go to Active Directory, users, all user. We have already user 1 created. We'll create a new user. User 2. Next. Next, create. We missed the display name, which is the user2, and create and create. Same and the user3. User three and create, and one more user four and create. So let's see all the users. Go to Active Directory, users, and we can see user 1, 2, 3, and for the refresh, and user 4 has appeared here. Now let's add user 1, user 2, and user 3 to their respective groups. So we'll go to Active Directory, we'll go to groups, and in group 1 we'll add a member who is going to be user 1. Same way we'll go to group 2 and we'll add a member, and we'll add a member as a user 2 for the group 2. Same way we'll go to group 3, add a member, users, and user 3. And user 4 is not any group member. So user 3 is the member of group 3, and I'll check for group 2 as well. Yes, we do have group 3 and user 2 member of the group 2. Same way we'll go to group 1, and after refresh, user 1 and group 2 are member of group 1. So we have successfully created the scenario. Now we will test on the license. Back to home page, we'll go to Active Directory, we'll go to groups, we'll go to group 1, and we'll go to licenses. We'll add assignment and Active Directory P2 license. We'll keep P1 only here and save. So license assigned successfully to group 1. Now we will wait for few minutes to update the license information. While the license is being updated on the groups, we'll go to user 4 and apply the license information. So we'll quickly go to user 4, licenses, and we'll assign the license to user 4. License assignment for user 4 failed. License assignment is failed due to usage location specification for that particular user. So we will go to user 4 and update the usage location. Go to Active Directory, users, user 4, edit properties, settings, and usage location. Here we will select India. This is required because of legal requirements. So we'll select India. Now go to user 4 and apply the license. User 4, licenses, assignment, and we'll select E1 and save. License is assigned successfully. Now let's go back to Active Directory and check our group 1, that where we have applied group 1 the licenses. So let's see, in the group 1 we do have members here, we do have group 2 is a member, and group user 1 is a member as well. So let's check the members or users of Active Directory. So user 1 is a direct member of group 1, therefore we'll check if user 1 has that license or not. We'll go to license tab under the user 1. We can see here that Active Directory Premium 2 license is active and it is inherited from the group 1. So user 1 automatically got this license because the user 1 is the member of group 1. So let's see if group 2, which is also the member of group 1, has got this license or not. So we'll go to the user 2 is the member of group 2. Again, the group 2 is the member of group 1. So we'll go to user 2, we'll go to licenses, and we can see no license is assigned to user 2. Again, let's go back and see for user 3, and we'll go to licenses, and we can see no license is assigned for that user as well. And definitely user 4 has the direct license assignment, therefore it should have the license, so it has direct license in place. So it is clear from our exercise that when we do have multiple groups and groups are having subgroups, so group 2 is even the member of group 1, but whoever the member of group 2 is not having any license assigned. However, the group 1 members have license automatically assigned. So back to our diagram. So if we assign the license, Microsoft license, to group 1, it will not be applicable to group 2. However, the group 2 is the member of group 1, but it will not be applied to group 2, and it will be applied to direct member of group 1, means user 1, and it will not be applied to user 2, user 3 and group 3 members. So and the group or user 4 is direct, you know, we have assigned the license to user 4 directly, therefore it will have license. So keep in mind that when we apply licenses to any group and it is having subgroups in it, it will not be applicable to subgroup and its members. So it will only be applicable to direct member of that group, means direct users in that group. So from this lab test we know that option B is correct here, user 1 and user 4 only, because user 4 is direct member and user 1 is the member of group 1. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching this video. Press the bell notification icon to receive the notification. Share with your friends. Thank you. See you next video.